little beautiful beloveds. So happy to have you here today. Today our theme is Hips Don't Lie, and isn't that the truth? So there are various benefits to hip openers, both the physical benefits and the spiritual, emotional, and mental benefits of hip openers as well. So I'll interweave all of that in this class so that you can experience from wherever your starting point is all of the benefits of hip openers. But one thing for sure, hip openers are like truth serum. So back to Shakira's wisdom, hips don't lie. Well, that actually is true. Our fears, our worries, our emotions get trapped into our hips. They are a sort of diary that tracks all the things that happen to us. And when we don't release some of that emotional accumulation, then we start to feel tightness physically. And what happens then is that the tightness in the hips, well, they're not doing the work they should. And then the back has to do more work, the knees kind of take a hit, and all this outsourcing doesn't help the body feel better, and it creates dysfunctional patterns of moving and being in the body. So we are going to relieve that. But more than anything, I want you to feel lighter at the end of this practice. I want you to feel like you can expand your wings and all the way out. Expand all the way into your greatest aspirations and your dreams, and that can make all the difference in your quality of life, in your happiest life. So let's get started, shall we? We're gonna lie down in Supta means reclined, Baddha Konasana, bound ankle pose, also in English known as cobbler. I will recommend that you use bricks or blankets underneath your knees, especially here at the start, so that you feel supported and you can surrender, relax, and start to flush things out. So this is the position, but turn towards the short side of your mat, bottoms of your feet together, put the bricks underneath your thigh, the knee, and if one knee is higher than the other, we don't try to come down with the knee that's a little higher, saying that the hip is tighter. We actually lift the other hip, so there's less strain. So just know that there's different heights, and then come on down. And then from here, you're gonna bring your first finger and your thumbs together, and they'll make a triangle pose. And then bring your thumbs to your belly button, first fingers down, and in this triangle shape, this little mudra, every pose we do is a mudra, everything's a pose, in other words. We're just putting our thumbs there by the belly button, and then the first fingers down. This yantra, the symbol of the second chakra, the sacral chakra, related to the water element, and what governs our emotions. And then deepen your breath. If it, right now you feel numb to your emotions, like you can't feel anything, then we may be experiencing emotional constipation. There's no flow. Or maybe there's a repeated situation that you see occur in your life over and over again, because we're not moving through the emotions from the previous situation. And until we learn the lessons, we'll just continue to catch that same wave. So flushing out what gets stored here in the hips. Deepen your breath into your abdomen, the low chamber of the lungs, and know that your lungs are so stretchy, the bottoms go all the way to your hip creases, and then all the way up the base of your throat. But this lower part of the lungs is where we often have very little movement, and this is the movement we need to move out the second, and then down and out through the releasing down. And if this is stuck, then anything that occurs in the higher chakras as well cannot flush out. So deep belly breathing. Enough that you can feel your hands move because you're filling your abdomen with breath. This is also calming to the central nervous system, CNS. Think of it as a reset. Bring your hands to help your knees together. Open your feet as wide as the mat and let your knees fall together, toes kind of in. And from that symmetrical pose of two external rotations, knees out from the line, we're now getting the counterbalance, knees in, internal rotation, and symmetrical for right now. In this moment, open the little door to the root chakra. You'll feel it in the bottom of your pelvic floor, your perineum, and think of it as open. So every emotion that's occurring can flush out and down. And bring your legs back to center, walk your feet in, knees above ankles, arms next to us. Press down the back of your arms so that you feel your shoulder blades come together, but then neutralize your pelvis so that we're not overly lordotic and dropped in the hinge of our low back. Now keeping this will engage your glutes to lift to bridge. This too is symmetrical, and this is extending the hip joint. We're opening, in other words, for extension is opening the hip joint here in front. And you're feeling that occur from the strength of your glutes and your legs, contraction of your hamstring. Inhale, exhale, come down without dropping anything faster than anything else. Just come down nice and easy and flat. Take a breath. Exhale. Draw your right knee in and start to circle around in your hip joint. This is now asymmetrical. Go in the other direction. Of our two joints, the hinge joints and the ball and sockets, the hip is a ball and socket. And then go in the direction you know you need an extra, whichever one that is for you. Lubricating the joint. And then right foot down. Extend your legs, stretch your arms, take a breath. Exhale, and just notice how you feel. As we try to tap back into this current of emotion, the emotional alchemy, how am I feeling? How does your right side feel different than your left? From just that one small thing that we did differently. Slide your feet in, lower your arms, but robot your arms this time. Elbow points down, press down, hug in the scapula along your spine, and then neutral spine. So you feel like your pelvic position is super strong, stable, pelvic mobility and strength, and engage your glutes, hug to the midline to lift up. Extending again the hip joint in bridge. Still hugging to the midline. You should feel the bottoms of your feet equally, insides and outsides, and the back of your legs. So yes, flexibility is important in the hips, but also strength is important. Inhale, exhale, come down nice and easy. Release your arms and then draw your left knee. And you could use one or both hands to help this knee move around. On the other direction. Go in the direction you need more of. How do you know? Well, it'll feel kind of like rough, sticky. You can't do it wrong. We're just helping lubricate the joints so that they're not so dry. Otherwise, our joints get drier every year we age, and there's a lot of air element in the joints, and then we get brittle. If you think of like something drying out. Okay? And then from here, open your knees second time and just notice the difference now that we've done both the right and the left. Stop feeling a little bit more open. Remember that this is a practice in millimeters, so it doesn't necessarily mean like miles more open, it could just be millimeters more open. And straighten your legs, knees towards your chest, hug them in, and then make little circles on your back. Go in both directions. Just this supine child's pose is so good. They are above the waistband of our pants, kidneys, above them the adrenal glands, stored cortisol, stress hormone. And find the still point, open your knees and close your knees. Open and close. Open, internal rotation, abduction, away from the middle, abduction. Together, abduction. Away, abduction. Together, internal rotation. Away, external rotation. Stay there and stretch your legs up to the sky and then back down. Internal rotation and then external rotation. Up and down. Inhale, exhale, descend. Inhale, extend. Exhale, move down. Inhale, expand. Get lighter. Exhale, release. Inhale. Exhale. And then knees together. Nice. Bring your feet to the ground. Right ankle over your left knee. Shape of a number four pigeon shape. And push down on your left foot so you feel long and you feel strong in your pelvis. Pressing your right knee away with your mind, right foot flat. A couple breaths here so that we can learn the emotional spectrum, not just the loudest emotions and paying attention to only those, but get underneath the surface and look at the more subtle emotions. So the sensation here is less, it's more subtle, nuanced. And now lift your left foot into the air. With your right hand, press your knee away and pull in with the left knee. Left knee comes towards you, right knee away, doing both, like a little conversation. Right hand down, inhale. Exhale, left foot taps the ground, but try not to lose the pelvic stability. Inhale, lift. Draw in as much or as little as you want. Exhale. Try not to hyperlift your low back to come down. Inhale, lift. Left hand can go on your belly. Exhale, down. Keeping your belly moving down, whether the leg is lifting or lowering, and maintaining both sides of your back on the ground so the pelvis stays nice and calm. Foot down, right foot to the left. And here, flatten the foot. Press the knee away, and arms could go up overhead, over to the right, or you could do this very traditionally, arms to a T. This is a twist, but we're opening this right hip pocket. Inhale, center, exhale, right foot down. Arms down, the apron somewhere. And then left ankle over our right thigh, and just press your left knee away, push down forward through the right foot, as if it was sliding forward. Now
notice your pelvis. It's going to stay in this shape. See if you can feel something in the hip, a softer message, quieter emotion. They get stuck in there too. And then right foot lifts. Your right thigh is trying to come closer with your left hand. Press your left knee away and do that at the same time. Right knee is moving in, left knee is moving away. This is also the shape of Warrior Two. You have an external rotation in the front leg and internal in the back leg. Hands down, take a breath. Exhale, lower your foot. Inhale up. As you do this, try not to roll to one side of your low back or the other. Just keep it nice and even. Next time down, let your left foot come all the way down to the left and press your left knee not towards you in this twist, but away from you. Arms can come up and over, lean left, or again, traditional, just arms to a T as you're in this twist. You should feel a stretch even a little bit in the flank muscle. The flank muscle is referring to your gluten-free vegan love handles. Just kidding. And then come back. Nice. And then left foot comes down. Stretch your legs all the way up. Arms move with your head, take a breath. Exhale, draw your knees in. Now hands are gonna come to the backs of our thighs. And as you pull your legs towards you with your hands, push your legs away with your legs. Do both and lift your head and shoulders. Now with that and with that momentum, come up to hover. Okay, just hovering. Now open your knees apart. Bottoms of your feet are together. This is Baddha-Konasana, Navasana, so cobbler boat. And then feet to the ground. You can use your bricks or move your bricks. Take a breath and then exhale, hold forward. Inhale, lift up. Notice how that feels. And then exhale, bring your hands behind you. Fingers facing forward. Box the feet on the ground. Hug your shoulder blades together. Neutral pelvis, so you're not like moving it in an unnatural position, but it's neutral. And from there, lift up. And you'll notice that in this upside down table, you're gonna be nice and even. Gaze up, gaze forward, gaze back. Three, two, one. Lower down slow. Right ankle above the left thigh, and then press your right knee away. If this is not enough sensation, bring your left foot closer. You could even hug it all the way in. Or if it's too much sensation, walk your hands further back. Inhale. Exhale, right foot to the ground. Again, instead of pushing the knee towards you, press it away. Move a little to the right as your legs are to the left. Center. Inhale, center. Exhale, release. Lean back, neutralize your pelvis. Lift up, inhale. Gaze where it feels really good. Inhale, look forward. Exhale, down. Left ankle below the right knee. And it can come really close. It can come so close that your chest can touch your lower leg, right? Like that close. Seated pigeon. Inhale. Exhale, left foot flat to the ground. Open the ankle of the knee away. Could look a little bit to the right. Come back to center, leg back. Left foot down, inhale, lift up, last one.
Uttanasana variation.
If you're looking back and forward, walk your hands forward, transition your hands to the front plane, Malasana. Now, instead of sagging and dropping into your hip joints, bring your elbows to your knees, push down. This is the seesaw principle. If you, one side goes down, something goes up. If you push your elbows down, that will lift you out of your hip joints an inch, a little bit. Yeah, we want that. Then hands together at the heart. Rather than just sagging and collapsing in the hip joints, try to strengthen your hips. We want flexibility and strength, equal parts in our hips. And strength is not the same as tightness. Inhale. Exhale, hands to the ground. Inhale, lift your hips, look behind you. Exhale, descend your hips, look forward. Inhale, lift your hips. Exhale, squat down. Keep going. If you need or find helpful your bricks, tall, medium, low, or no bricks, but strengthening through repetition and also creating some mobility. How many of these? Well, more than one, more than three. A few. Last time up, turn your toes forward and forward fold, Uttanasana. If you're using bricks for forward fold, that's cool. Reach for opposite elbows and just sway around, be like water, and notice if your hamstrings feel more open. So when our hips get tight, then our low back tends to do the work. And then our knees do the work, but they shouldn't be doing that work. That's the work of the hips. So then they get tight. But if you open your hips, you're gonna find that, wow, my hamstrings just feel like they got longer, so to speak. Arms release. Inhale, all the way up. Spread your wings. Reach up. Exhale. Hands down to the heart center. And then turn your palms open, facing forward. And then arms out a little bit. Just close your eyes for a moment and notice from all that you've done, how much lighter you feel. Just from that, like that is the golden preparation, just to be able to do the rest of the practice. To release the heaviness. Find the lightness. And if you weren't worried about what other people thought, whether other people accepted you, you weren't worried or afraid of other people's judgments, or worried if people loved you or not, or never again seeking approval from others, trying to be overly perfect, ourselves, if all of these emotions related to those things, if they were gone as we emptied them out, we flushed them out, and we felt lighter, if you weren't afraid, what would you do? How would you live your life today? Put your palms over your heart and just hold that to yourself. Your hands, open your eyes, spread your wings, let's fly, inhale, circle out and up, exhale, open and dive, salutation gate, inhale, halfway lifting, exhale, plank, knees down or not, take a breath, exhale, halfway or all the way to your belly, inhale, low, medium, high, cobra, or the upward dog. Notice how your back bones feel from all the hip opening. Exhale, down, facing down. Here, delight in the fact that, like, wow, your shoulders may feel like infinitely wider, easier, like your wings got bigger. All from releasing heaviness in the hips. Inhale, lift your heels. Exhale, bend your knees, look forward, step, walk, or jump. Inhale, half lifting. This is Sun Salutation A, traditional. Exhale, fold. Spread your wings. Come all the way out of the way. Exhale, hands to the heart center. And then palms open again. I want you to imagine a butterfly. And that you are that butterfly. So think of what color you are as a butterfly. How big your wings are as a butterfly. And then imagine on one of your little butterfly legs, there is a string attached to a huge rock. And no matter how big your wings are, how much you desire to feel light and free and expand, you're carrying all this heavy weight. And it's so much harder. Palms come back together. So again, promise yourself every exhalation, you're releasing and flushing out the heaviness so that you can literally undo that cord and let go of the weight, that rock go. Inhale, circle your wings out and up. Feel the lightness without that cord. Exhale, fold, Sun Salutation A. Inhale, half lifting. Exhale, step back plank or modify plank. Breathe in. Exhale, flow low, halfway or to your navel. Inhale, up dog or cobra. Exhale, downward facing dog. Breathing in, breathing out. So maybe down dog now feels just so much lighter. I hope so. Bring your big toes to touch. Inhale, lift your heels. Exhale, open your knees out, frog dog. Inhale, squeeze your inner knees and leg line together. Exhale, frog dog. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale, hop, land with your knees apart. Hop, if you want. Try that a couple times. And then at some point, jump forward or walk forward. Inhale, halfway lifting. Exhale, fold. Inhale, open your wings. We're light. Exhale, fold down. Inhale, left leg extends. Exhale, left foot to the back of the mat. Inhale, bend your front knee. This is closing the ankle or the hip joint. Now exhale, open that ankle. Inhale, lunge. Exhale, high pyramid. Back heel will never touch the ground. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale, exhale, back heel down, toes to 45 degrees. Inhale, circle up, warrior two. Stay for the exhale. Inhale, both arms up. Lighten up, open the ankle. Exhale, close it. Inhale up. Notice if your pelvis is unstable in a peaked position on one side, and then exhale. Go from mobility and stability in equal parts. Couple, three more. Like you're moving through water. And on that last time, stay there. Deepen the breath and allow the flushing out through the little door of the root chakra you opened. So just flush things out. Stuck emotion, fear, agitation, worry, anxiety. Right palm open, left hand down. Inhale, right arm up, front leg straightens. It wants to open up, otherwise it gets tired. Exhale, hands cartwheel down, back heel lifts. Inhale, one-legged plank. Exhale, either two-footed, flow low, or sweep this part and make your way to downward facing dog. Breathe in, breathe out. big toes together and walk a little forward. Exhale, frog dog, look forward. Inhale, lean forward, more like a plank. Exhale, press back, knees wide. Inhale, hop. Down. And then at some point, hop forward or step forward. Inhale, hop, lifting. Exhale, folding. Inhale, right leg extends. Exhale, right leg to the back. Look forward, breathe in. Exhale, both legs straight. Breathe out. Inhale, front leg bends. Exhale. And go back and forth a couple, three times. Next time you're bent in your left knee above ankle, stay here. Right toes are to about 45 degrees. The toes, the knee facing that side. Inhale, circle your arms out and come to warrior two. External rotation in the left leg. Inhale, both arms up. Even your pelvis squeezed in the midline. And then exhale, soften. Inhale, hug it, add up. Squeeze your legs together. Get a little higher. Exhale, release some of the heaviness in the hips. Breathe in to feel your aspirations. Breathe out to release some of the pent-up emotion. A couple more times. So if you think about what you're putting into these shapes, you'll get more out. Next time, stay. Find the sensation, let it bring up, like it's stirring the pot. Let it bring up what it needs to bring up and to dislodge. That emotion that we are denying, pretending it's not there, or we did only surface healing. Right hand down, left palm open. Let's give this left hip a break. Inhale, left arm up, straighten your left leg. Open that ankle with the joint. Exhale, cartwheel down. Back heel up so you're safe. Inhale, one-legged plank. Exhale, either down dog or float. Halfway to Chaturanga to your belly, to up dog or cobra. Breathe in. Breathe out. Left foot to right foot. Inhale, right leg lifts. Open your hip. So that is external rotation, and then flex your foot like you're kicking away. Now squeeze your heel towards your bum. It's still external rotation. Now straighten leg. So this is the shape of half moon bees. Squeeze your legs together a little bit. Inhale. Exhale, right foot lowers. Inhale, lift your heels. Step, walk, or jump forward fold. Bring your brick. One or two in front, low, medium, high. Inhale, lift your right leg, internal rotation. Exhale, open your hip, okay? If you don't need a brick, don't use a brick. This is the same position that you just had in downward dog. And then add the lifting of your right arm. Half moon B, Ardhachandrasana B. Your wings are broad. Now, if you wish, you could bend that leg at your knee hinge and hold your ankle and press your leg out as your hand pulls it. Chaturanga. Re-extend, if you're doing that, breathe in. Exhale, right hand down first, then square your hips, then lower your right leg, forward fold. Inhale, half lifting. Exhale, step back plank. Take a breath. Decide the basic connecting vinyasa or take it to down dog. But either way, it's five breaths of either moving through plank, chaturanga, up dog, to down dog, or straight to down dog. From here, right foot comes a little closer to your left. Squeeze the floor with your fingers. Wings are long. Inhale, left leg lifts, internal rotation. Exhale, open your hip, stacking it, and flex your foot. So your left hip is literally on your right, and your legs are moving away from one another, while at the same time you feel them squeezing together so that your pelvis feels very stable. This is half moon or variation, squeezing your heel in. Point your toes. Now extend, close your hips, and lower your leg. Now, a fun transition is to jump forward to land on your right foot. I'm going to show it to you, and then I'll talk us through the original way. Lift your heels, inhale, look forward, exhale, bend your knees, land on your right foot, inhale, left leg up, hip open, left arm up, arch and vasana B. Okay? Let's go back, downward dog. Inhale, lift your heels. Exhale, look forward. And step, walk, or jump. Feet together. This is the original way. Get your brick, prepare it. Over to your right foot. Not so much middle, but a little bit more to the right. Or not. Inhale, lift your left leg. Hips are closed, internal rotation. Now, exhale. Open your hips. Stack your left hip on your right hip. Left hand all the way up, spread your wings. Your feelings if you're squeezing your legs together for pelvic stability and expanding, lifting. Now if you want, you could bend your leg, reach back to the top of your foot or ankle. Do this variation only if you want. Or do that in place of the open leg, but everybody open up, inhale. Exhale, left hand down first. Close your hips. Left foot down. Forward fold. Inhale, lift up. Exhale, bend your knees. Keep your hands. And lean your knees into your elbows. Just activate your fingertips. Lean forward, look forward, and flex your feet. And it's not about how high your feet come off the ground, but if you just flex them, and you squeeze in with your legs and press out at the same time, then they will lift, right? There has to be enough pelvic stability equal to the flexibility. Feet down, we're in Malasana. Then have a seat without your hands. So this is Baddha. Take a breath, exhale, fold. Inhale, come up. Lean back, exhale, belly in, lift your feet, and now reach your arms, flex your hands, palms out, squeeze your knees towards one another, adduction, but press out with your arms. This is crow pose. We're just happening to do it seated. This is crow pose. Take a breath, and then exhale, feet down, place your hands, squeeze in, flex your feet, gaze up. And put the weight to your fingertips rather than the heels. Your heels of your hands are your brakes. The fingertips are the accelerator. And come down when you need a little rest. Okay? A quick technique is if you're afraid, because this is meant to like trigger stuff and bring stuff up. Like, I'm afraid of what? I'm afraid of falling. I'm afraid of failing. I'm afraid of not being perfect. So you could put the crown of your head, or rather the forehead, on the brick. Lean forward and notice like you're falling, but this is a controlled falling with your head down. Now, if the brick is right between your hands, this is not going to work. It actually has to create a tripod. You have to give yourself space, but when all our weight is in the past, the posterior parts of the feet, if we're like in a forward fold or back here, yeah, or in the arm balance, we resist the forward momentum. Then that's literally saying what's holding us back is our past, emotions, stories that are stuck inside us. Once you flush that out, yeah? So if you're afraid, put it there, flex your feet. Feet could be apart, feet could be together. But enjoy a couple deep breaths. Until that point, you're like, all right. Now I'm going to attempt it without the brick. feet down, nice and easy. And then have a seat. Pick your left leg up. Wiggle your right foot over. And just maybe cradle this leg. Loosen it up a little bit. Extend, bend, extend, bend, sort of like air guitar. You could even listen to your foot and hold the support. And then bring your left ankle over your knee, knee and ankle, ankle, knee. And from here, take a breath and double pigeon, Adho Mukha Svanasana. You might lean forward and go like, wow, that is some sensation. What is stuck in my hips there? I didn't know that. Or some of us, like depending where you are on the path, you have to literally look for the sensation. So you can walk your hands around, you can move like water, and just be like, okay, where is it that I'm meant to flush up, get some other stagnant energy and emotion? And you can be here a while. You can stack bricks as high as you need them, or pillows. And just be with the emotion that comes up. You can see it, name it, appreciate it, acknowledge it. Push pause on this video to stay there longer, do that. Come up otherwise, and without your hands or with your hands, take your left foot back, toes under. Keep this angle of your right knee in this pigeon shape. Take a breath, walk your fingertips back. Exhale, wash like water. Inhale, lift. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Same thing again. Maybe you need to move around in it to try to find where is that sensation, you know? Or maybe you need just to be still and let it flush out and see the flushing. And you can support this with bricks or a pillow in front of you. But let the root chakra stay open so that the water has somewhere to move through, down. You could stay here for a very long time, meeting each emotion like a guest at the door. So this too is a great place to press pause if you need longer, otherwise come up. From here, just bring your leg around, undo your legs, and just move around a little bit, right? Whatever that may mean to you, right? But we've dislodged something, so like literally we just move it all the way through. To release. And then when you're ready, bring your left shin parallel to the short front side of the mat. Pick your right foot up with your left hand to support your right knee. And then just cradle, cradle, cradle. Circle, circle, circle. This is not enough sensation. Right foot to left inner elbow. Circling, circling. Extend and bend, extend and bend, and then knee to ankle, ankle to knee, double pigeon. If your knee is far away, you could put a brick and support it, yeah, it's way up here. Again, if you feel sensation, then just stay with it and talk to it. What emotion is that? Or, again, for some of us, we actually have to look for those deeper layers. What is stuck in the subconscious? It's like not just emotion from yesterday, last year, but 10 years ago, third grade. Like, where Where is it? And then just be wherever you need to be with that sensation, with the emotion of the sensation. You could pause the video here. Otherwise, come up from Agni Snabhasana, Fire Log Pose, Double Pigeon. Bring your right leg back, knees under. Keep your left shin as it is. Walk in, take a breath, and let water flow forward. Catch the wave, inhale. Exhale. Breathe back, and wave forward. And then look around for it, move around. Or settle into it. So wherever it is, you're like, okay, that's the sensation that I'm going to flush out now. Find that one. Let it wash out. Move down and out to the earth from your left hip. So you could still be moving. You could be still. Whatever's helping you to dislodge it and flush it. And then once that's flushed out, we may have to find another one again. Oh, okay. And then flush that one. Started, bottoms of the feet together, bricks underneath our knees, and make sure you have space to lie down. Making a little triangle if you wish. Soul self, your emotional self, your spiritual self, feel light. And feel as if you're floating into the sky above you and coming to find a fluffy white cloud to rest upon, feeling so light. Light in your heart and full of possibilities. Resting on the cloud and the sky with your dreams and your highest aspirations. Begin to deepen your breath or stay here longer. And with every breath, let yourself descend from the cloud back into your body. And it's like you have a brand new body. That lightness. Circle your wrists. Feel your belly. your legs, drop into your heart. We're all around lighter now. Stretch your legs and your arms, breathe in, and then exhale. Just allow yourself to be here in this relaxed, really big, expanded form, ever so light, and heart, mind, and body. Staying there. Well, I seal and close this practice. Grateful for you to be here, grateful for this time together. My heart to your heart, to the heart of the universe. May you love yourself, love your day, and love your life. Muchísimas gracias. Gracias mil. Te amo casi. Sixama. Merci beaucoup. Como amo.